Anglican clergy have their last field day, things spiritual are already giving way to things temporal, for the majority at least. Unfortunately, by no means everybody in Mauritius is in favour of independence. And as the day dawned, it became clear that nearly half the population were determined to boycott the whole thing. The rest, mostly Indians, wanted to celebrate. In one thing only was the entire population wholly united. All of them rejoiced in the fact that Her Royal Highness Princess Alexandra, true representative of the Queen of England, was going to do them the honour of presiding over their independence celebrations. But at the last minute, the British government, anxious to avoid the remotest possibility of another bit of bad publicity, at home that is, not abroad, decided not to send the royal couple. So the governor stood in for the Queen, and Colonel Hefford ensured that everything went ahead almost as planned. Instead of the princess, a former colonial secretary, Mr. Anthony Greenwood, who, on his only previous visit to the island, had a stone chucked at his car by a bored bystander. Somewhere in the crowd, a disillusioned lady police sergeant and a policeman back on traffic duty tried to carry on as though nothing had happened.
Morning. And it is a lovely morning, too. Morning.
This, after all, is an occasion for self-congratulation, for demonstrating a bit of independence as well as achieving it. And all nations, however peacefully they get their freedom, must remind themselves of the shackles of colonialism and convince themselves that winning their independence has all been a terrific struggle. Mauritius is no exception. The floats, manned by third-generation Indian immigrants, recall the fierce battles of the past, the heroic achievements of their country. The Communist Chinese contingent, all sporting a little red cap in honour of Chairman Mao, put their dragon through its paces, happily joining their imperialist cousins in the last salute to the Union Jack. The symbolic moment is over, but the swearing-in of the ministers and the state opening of Parliament and many other ceremonies still lie ahead.